Every year we get to see one race car that has just about every color you can imagine on it, and it looks stunning on the racetrack. Here's Kyle Busch's 2020 M&Ms Toyota Camry. Howdy, folks. It is Diecast Buffet here again, back with another NASCAR Diecast review. And let me tell you, man, this car is sweet. It is Kyle Busch's 2020 M&Ms Toyota Camry, and holy cow, I'll be darned if you cannot see every color on the rainbow on this freaking car, man. Holy cow, this thing is fantastic. Now, this paint scheme is iconic. This will be Kyle Busch's Hall of Fame paint scheme. You know, it's like Logano. It's going to be the Penske Scallops. That's going to be his Hall of Fame car. This is going to be his style of Hall of Fame car, the M&Ms cars from the 2010s. I tell you, man, this car, holy cow, man, it's such a simple paint scheme, but then again, it's not. I mean, like, you got M&Ms all over the car and a yellow base paint. Beautiful. I mean, they really outdone themselves when Kyle Busch took over the ride in 2008 compared to yesteryear with, you know, they had, Elliott Sadler, and then they had, David Gilliland, you know, those cats driving the 38 car with the M&M sponsor. But man, when they went to Joe Gibbs Racing, they really cranked it up. This is a 2020 diecast. You can see the maroon ribbon around the box. This is for 2020. And holy cow, man. This is the second Kyle Busch car already. Yeah, this is the second one. They released the Interstate Batteries one first. And I'm so glad they did that, because that car is probably diecast of the year, honestly. And if you want to see that review, link down below. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get this 2020 Kyle Busch M&Ms Toyota Camry out of the box. Here it is, folks, brand new out of the package. And wow, look at that number 18 right there, folks. That is indeed a oopsie. I mean, check this out, folks. Look at that. What is this? Is this freaking like a Easter egg paint? What is this? And believe it or not, it's freaking smooth. So this was put on the car. The decal was screwed up like this, and they freaking clear coated it. It is smooth. Like, are you freaking kidding me? Oh, did that just chip right there? Oh my god. So you got the, whatever this is over here. Is this a bullet hole, or is this a freaking, just a piece of a decal overlap? I don't freaking know. I think that's actually a bullet hole, because my nail's catching, so, that is cool. So we're going ahead and, starting this diecast review with a bang, pun intended with the bullet hole reference. But anyways, here is Kyle Busch's 2020 M&Ms Camry, and holy cow, man. Look, there's probably two paint schemes that really look freaking good in a stop motion. And one of them is easily Kyle Busch's M&M's car. I mean, you've seen it for the past decade or so. This is the car to have in your stop motions. It's bright, it's beautiful, it's colorful. The other one, well, is probably anything Chase Elliott related, of course. Not biased. I'll probably be like a Menards car, honestly, because those things, holy cow, those things are beautiful. Anyway, so this is a car that got released very recently. This is a car also that almost won the 500. Kyle Busch, honest to God, I thought he was going to win the 500. Last year, I picked him to win it. He got second. He was running up front. It was about, 50 to go in the dead of night at Daytona, and good Lord, his engine expires. And I tell you what, That post-race interview, or during the race, when he got out of the car, he was in the garage, and they were still running laps, and they were talking to him. Man, he was so dejected. Oh my god. So over here to the hood of the car, you got a green M&M, you got a red M&M, and ooh, we got a blue M&M. Apparently, they're just literally taking paintbrushes, and they're just painting these on now. You know, is it just me, or does it seem like every year of these diecasts, they seem more and more like custom quality? And what I say by that is that the quality, like the actual, like the decal wrap, the placement of the items on the car, get worse and worse. It seems like a custom car you're buying now. So you got the Toyota Camry logo. That thing looks like it is all kinds of skewed out. Reminds you of like with those 07 Gen 4 cars when the nose is all wonky jaw. That's what it looks like. So you got Camry here, the whole front fascia is completely off center. I mean, look at that. Wow. So you got a beat in Toyota Camry. Actually kind of looks cool like that. It kind of does look like a three-dimensional dent, you know, like boom. Looks pretty cool. So you got the Camry, you got the Toyota logo, got the 18 there. Wow, only a little Sunoco logo there. You got a paint chip over here on the splitter, so that's cool. Hopefully you didn't find another jackrabbit at Sonoma. Oops. So you go over here to the left side of the car. I mean, once again, we've already, you know, touched base with the whatever this is. I mean, literally, it's clear coated. Like this, it's freaking clear coated. My lord, they knew that was there. They still sprayed this thing. So you got Kyle Busch's signature there. I do like that. The old, you know, fashioned, you know, cursive autograph. You got, what is this? You got Stanley. You got the big red M&M just pointing at you. He's got a, I guess he's got a boo-boo on his finger. That's why he's pointing. He needs a Band-Aid or something. So you got the ring logo there. You got American Ethanol. You got a tail light going through his eye. You got, what is it? M&M's, Interstate Batteries, Freightliners. Simeon's Mobile One, Cessna, Sherwin-Williams, whatever that is, Lincoln Welders, Mack Tools. Notice the paint scheme does go down to the side skirts, and I would love to see a, what is it, the 2010, 2009 Kyle Busch car where it had like the diamond plate back bumper and like the side skirts or whatnot. Man, that would be a cool throwback. So you got NASCAR race car, you got NASCAR Cup Series, 3M, K&N, or the Toyota First Win Snickers car. I think that would be really cool to see on a Gen 6 car, and of course you got Lincoln Welders there. You do got a slight decal overlap there. Eh, not too bad though, but you got the Goodyear logo. It's a little bit wonky jaw as usual. Over here on the B post, you got Toyota, Joe Gibbs Racing, Snickers, Twix. Why can't we get a Twix Cup car? That'd be freaking cool. Skittles, Pedigree, which the Pedigree car literally got DMP'd for like 5 years in a row. It's like, why even offer it if you're gonna DMP it within a week? It's like, why? And then, of course, you got whatever that is. That Joe Gibbs himself? I don't know what that is. And then over here to the back bumper of the car, it's pretty sophisticated. Just a straight up M&M's yellow. Got the Camry logo, XSE. You got the M&M's, M&M. However you pronounce it. So is that considered a word or like a text font, or is that considered a brand logo? Like Toyota right there, that's a text font, right? That's their, you know, their actual name. And that right there is their logo. So is that considered a word logo, or is that considered a brand, you know, actual like insignia type of logo? Who knows? I love the white and black 18 there. It looks very good. Honestly, the back end of the car, besides a little bit of a wonky jaw middle trunk decal, looks pretty good. I like that. I noticed that the Toyota logo is a little bit more darker this year, which, honestly, I kind of liked it a little bit brighter, just a hair more, but I'm not going to nitpick too much. This is a pretty cool looking car. And then you go over here to the right side of the car, you got the giant yellow M&M here who's pretty much waving at you, say, stop, gotta have the 6 feet, gotta get away, man, you're coughing, don't get over here. So you got him over there. I think he's the peanut one, I think. So you got the Kyle Busch autograph there. Got another bullet hole over here on the NASCAR race car logo. That's great. Got some racewear scratches over here. Got the 18 goes all the way down to the side skirt, just like the blue one. And you can see how the colors are different. How this one has the green, this one has the orange, it has the blue, that has the red. And you got yellow here, which almost blends in, honestly. But yeah, I would, oh dude, I would love to see a Kenny Schrader throwback to 2002. Dude, if they made a Kyle Busch 2002 Kenny Schrader M&M's car, I would freaking go nuts for that thing. Like, and then over here to the roof of the car, you got the traditional Joe Gibbs Racing 18. I hope they never change the font for that. I mean, honestly, that thing has become so iconic with Dale Jarrett to Bobby Labonte, Skip J.J. Yaley, and then Kyle Busch. That is a very popular and, in my opinion, iconic number in NASCAR. Love that. You got the M&M's. I guess you call it the M&M's banner, I guess. I don't freaking know. So you got the little, you got a snort line there of M&M's. You got the Kyle Busch. You got the window decal there, his name banner. And then you got the big M&M's logo, which used to be on the side here back in the Elliott Sadler days, if I remember correctly. Anyways, folks, thank you all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give a big thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Of course, go ahead and follow me on Instagram for more NASCAR Diecast content at Diecast Buffet, of course. Hope you're having a great one. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see y'all guys in the next video. Diecast Buffet, signing off.